Good morning, my loves. I know I said I wouldn't be on here vlogging a whole bunch, but hold on, Eli wants to say hi.
Hi. Hi.
But I just figured, why not grab the camera? It's kind of like I've been vlogging so long now that it's kind of just like second nature to vlog. So I'm just getting breakfast ready. Something simple. I've been trying to do like healthier breakfasts. I'm watching someone live. But I just have toast and put some jelly, a little bit of butter on it, put some fruit for Eli, and probably give him a yogurt. And then me, I'm going to have my juice that I made. I actually made this a couple of days ago, like 2 or 3 days ago. So hopefully it's still, you know, good to go. Hey, you'll never keep me here. I hear freedom cry. I feel not chased by. I see Jesus coming. You'll never keep me here. I know my God is near. I know my God is near. Oh, oh. Eat your you ate all your bananas.
I'm serious now.
Banana face.
My glasses are so crooked.
Well, I used to call you.
Mmm, really good.
Sam?
Eli is enjoying my juice. He had to share. I didn't drink all of it, most of it. And I'm sitting here trying to combat my procrastination.
Hi.
Because I've literally been sitting here for about 10 minutes not doing anything, thinking about everything that I have to do, and then thinking about other stuff and just kind of getting overwhelmed. So I said I'm going to turn the camera back on, I'm going to hold myself accountable, and I'm going to be productive. So I'm going to go get my notepad, I'm going to write down the list of everything I have to do, and then I'm going to start doing it. I'm really thinking I need to put my computer back in the kitchen. The only reason I didn't like that is because I watch a lot of Netflix and stuff, like, at nighttime, or I'll turn on, like, the cartoons for Eli in the room, and it's just convenient. But, like, from a working perspective, it's a bit harder. I feel like if I'm in the kitchen, I can have Eli actually, he could play with his art easel, or I can have him playing with, like, Play-Doh while I'm working when I can't do that in the room. So I'm really thinking about doing that. Yeah, because I need to be productive and utilize my time the best way and not feel like I'm neglecting my child. So, yeah. Let me go get my notepad and get the list started. I'm about to make me a cup of green tea because I haven't had my ACV this morning. It's weird. It's like I'm not consciously focusing on my weight loss. Here, I'll do this. I was gonna say, I'm not consciously focusing on my weight loss, but I am kind of being conscious of what I intake, so to speak, if that makes sense. I'm almost out of my brags. It's getting low. Just wait a minute. But yeah, I put 2 capfuls, just the top of the cap, 2 capfuls into my cup. And fill my cup up with the green tea, and that's what I drink usually first thing in the morning, or I usually do it warm, but since I just made this, it's still warm, so I'm gonna do it that way. So
hi.
Eli decided to poop and pull his underwears and stuff up without getting his butt wiped. Fun stuff. So now that just kind of upped bath time on the list. So rather than do anything else that I was planning on doing before throwing him in the tub, I'm just going to go ahead and put him in the tub, get him cleaned up, get him dressed so that way he's done for later. Then he can eat lunch, and then maybe I can get some editing done. And then I'm going to hop in the shower. I don't think I'm going to try to get dressed up tonight for church at all, because I just
the day just got away from me.
Okay, just got Eli out the tub. Woohoo! We are about to get lotion. Hey, you never keep me here. I hear
freedom cry. I feel not chased by. Eli, you don't have to zip it up, booby. Look. Let me see all fit. Ooh, they're so nice. Let me see your pants. And your feet. Yay! He's so silly.
Here we go.
All right, so we just finished lunch. I'm like not even on schedule. Like, I've gotten, y'all, like three things. It looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things off of my list crossed off. I think I'm about to hop in the shower just so that I'm clean, so that I don't have to worry about that later, because I do have church tonight. And then when I get out the shower, I'll get dressed, and then I'm going to do some editing. I need to actually do, oh my gosh, my braid is slipping. I need to do a program. Yeah, like, get off that cord. I need to do a program, so I may do that. I'm not sure. I have so many things on my plate, you guys. Then I have tomorrow to get ready for, which I'm super excited about, you guys. Like, I told you in my previous vlogs, it's the first time doing anything like that. Just like, God is just opening up doors to network and communicate with people, and I'm so excited about it. So let me put this down and let me go put my shoe down, Eli.
Okay.
And hop in the shower, and then I'll be back to talk to you guys. I need to take these braids out. I said I was only leaving these in for a month, but I'm not sure what my next protective style is gonna be, because I wanted to hide my hair for 90 days. So I'm not even sure. I'm not even sure what to put in my hair. So I don't know. But yeah, see you guys in a bit.
Oh, mine.
You have to be behind mommy when I open up doors. Remember that?
I love that.
You gonna close the door for me?
Yeah,
oh my gosh, it feels like winter. Sorry, it's all close to my face. It feels like winter. Like, it don't feel like fall. It don't feel like spring. It feels like winter. Come on, Boops. He's ready. As you guys can tell, we don't get out much. Wait for mommy. Remember, you do not cross the street without mommy. Yeah. It's my baby. You never keep me here. I hear freedom cry. I feel not chased by. I see Jesus. I've got to put you on the stand. So I still haven't figured out exactly.
Hi.
What?
Hi.
What is that on my camera?
Hi.
Eli says hi.
Hi.
It's really cold. Oh crap, I totally forgot I didn't have any gas in my car. Oh no. No, 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 no. And I have to get out and pump gas, and I have no coat on. Oh no. I gotta put my specs on, y'all. I didn't forgot to put. Wait, where's my wallet? This is not cool. What time is it? Oh, I got like a half an hour. How did I forget to get gas? How did I forget I didn't have no gas? I have $2. Ooh, wait. I have $3. Okay. And I have $5 on my bank card. So, what are you doing?
I need help.
Push it down in there.
Thank you.
All right, so I'm gonna have to go. I mean, I could just go to Sheets and use my card, because I have $5 on there, and then just hop on the highway. I think that's probably gonna be my best bet. So, and I didn't bring no jacket. I ain't going back in the house, because then I'll really be late trying to fool around with stuff. I mean, I think I can make it to church with just what I have in my tank, but all I know is I need a deposit. I need a deposit, y'all, like yesterday, because this is not cool. See, because usually I go a different way, but since I don't have, oh look, the juice box came through. I'm using that forever, but since I don't have gas still in my car. I'm gonna go this way and put this gas in my car. Today was okay. I don't know, I think it's the weather. The weather just had me feeling like all lethargic and not feeling like doing anything and just cold and gloomy because it's been rainy. But I mean, I got some things done. I didn't get everything that I wanted to get done. And then I really need to, when I come home tonight, I thought that was like a break in my glass. When I come home tonight, I really need to hunker down and get all my stuff together for tomorrow because I have to be up stupid early because I have to be there early because I'm helping to set up. And I'm supposed to be taking pictures at the event, which I don't have a problem taking pictures of the actual event. I do have a problem with, I do have a problem if I have to print out photos, because I know that she said she wanted me to have that available and then they would just like charge a fee. Yeah, I don't know about that one because I'm just learning my printer. Like I printed out a print the other day and I do offer them, but that's with it straight from the computer to my printer. And my laptop, I would have to like clean that thing off, defragmented and all of that. So I don't know. I don't know about that one. I don't know. Yeah. So yeah, I don't know. I'm just, I said that like three times because but I really don't know. That scared me, them cop cars. But anywho, I've been watching so many of y'all vlogs. Shout out to Slay YouTube. Like, I don't know, I was feeling really funky for a minute, y'all, like about like joining groups and like, you know, I don't even know how to say it, because one, I know a lot of the people that I did subscribe to and that I've been showing love to their channels didn't subscribe back to me. And even if they did, they definitely aren't showing love like how I'm showing love on their videos. I'm not like, you know what I mean? And like I always was like apprehensive about doing things like that because I want my viewership to be authentic. I don't ever want it to be like, because you're not paying for it. I mean, you're just helping each other out, which is cool. But I'm like, I don't know, all of a sudden my analytics, like since I joined like the group, they've gone down. And it's not like when I joined this one group on YouTube called The Real Women of YouTube, the Bells Plus One started the group. It's not like that group, but this one is a little bit different. But like my analytics started to go down, and that's because people aren't watching my video all the way through, so my watch time got like even shorter. It was so crazy, and I was just like, oh man, like y'all, my numbers is getting messed up, which means the little bit of change I do make every once in a blue moon was getting messed up. So I kind of was like, I don't know if I want to still do this because it's messing up my numbers. But I'm just like, whatever. I just follow through. I've met some really genuine ladies. I found some really good channels through the group. So, I mean, I don't know. I don't know what the future holds, but I do know this. I'm just really trying to grow my channel as authentic as possible. And I would want, if my channel is not your cup of tea, like, support, yeah, just let my video play out to the end. You know, hit the like, drop a comment, you know what I mean? You don't have to subscribe, but if mine isn't your cup of tea, don't just come on my video and comment and not let it run all the way through, because if you do that, you're screwing up like the numbers. And it's sad because it's like I worked really hard to get to where I was at, and for you to just come and kind of ruin that just because you want me to come back and subscribe to your channel and, you know, give you views. I don't know, it just seems like that's kind of janky. But let me get out and pump this gas, y'all, so I can go to church and be on time. I'll be talking to you in a little bit. Give me a second, little bit. It is so cold. It is so cold, and I'm not looking forward to going out here. Oh, my eye biscuits, y'all. It's freezing out there. It ain't hot, baby. It's cold. I know. I don't know what I was thinking. I definitely wasn't trying to be cute, not with this grandmom skirt I got on. But Lord, I had to stop that machine. You try to go over my $5. I said, you ain't about to overdraft me. No, 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 sir. I got $5.29 in that bank account, and that's, I'm going to take $5.06 of it and throw it in my gas tank. Whew. Oh, the struggle. The struggle, the struggle, the struggle.
Hey, Lord, the struggle. You gonna keep slaying me? You gonna keep slaying me, son? You gonna keep on slaying mommy? You hear him back there, y'all? Tell him you need a jacket, mommy. Hey, with a quarter tank of gas. Hey, $45. Hey, $45. Hey. Let me stop. Not for real, I'm thankful. Because I might not have had nothing. And I don't know what I would have been doing. Let me turn on some heat up in this room, because we cold. We cold out here. Y'all, I was so hyped because one of the vloggers that I follow, on one of the days when I was feeling like pretty low, it must have been something going around in the atmosphere in the vlog community, because one of the bigger, I consider her channel huge. She might not consider her channel huge, but she got over 60K. Okay, that's bigger than what I got. That's 58K more than what I got, and I'm trying to get like her, okay? And she was just saying she was going through some things, like, and I think that's what people forget. I think literally that is what people forget. When they follow people or when they come across people's channels, they just forget that people are freaking humans. And at the end of the day, that we all have our own lives offline. And people like forget that. They make it seem like we're inhuman just because we post videos. And like, they don't even take into account that, like, how much time it takes to post a video, like, and to edit and to do all of that. Nobody takes that into consideration. They just want to come for you. So, but anywho, she had posted this video and was like, you know, I'm just taking some time. I don't know when I'll be back. I'm just, you know, just, I need to enjoy my kids. And like, that's how I was feeling. Like I'm not getting paid from this like that. Like, I think I get paid maybe once a year, because my analytics is not popping. My videos, ever since I stopped doing hair reviews, my video has started just vlogging full time. My videos have gone, my payment has gone. Which is cool, because I'm not doing it for the cash payout. Like I said, in the future, if that is what God has for me, awesome, amen, I'm here for it. Yes, give me that check. But if not, like, I'm good with it not being, you know what I mean? Because I enjoy doing this. This is a way to document my life and my son's life and my journey into motherhood, and to look back at the mistakes I made and look back at the good things I made, the good decisions that got me to this point. So that's where I'm at with that. But she left an awesome, she responded to my comment, and it was so encouraging, and I'll probably drop it in here. And it was just so awesome to have somebody, her take time out of her schedule to comment back. Like, I like, that's the type of vlogger and YouTuber I want to be. I want to always be not necessarily accessible to my viewers, but I want to make sure that I'm always interacting with you guys, because at the end of the day, we are nothing without subscribers. We are nothing without viewers. I won't say subscribers, because subscribers, you could have a million subscribers and only two people comment on your video, like, so, you know what I mean, they're really watching you. So, you know, I don't want to become one of those channels where, like, I know I seen a thread and people just like, if you want your views to get up, if you want your analytics, all that, do a bunch of reaction videos, find stuff that's relevant, do this. And I'm like, I don't want to make videos like that, because I'm not looking for YouTube to be a check, because you're gonna burn yourself out. If that's what you truly want to do, is nothing but reaction videos and pranks and challenges, if that's what you want to do, cool. But like, if it's not, if your heart's not in it, you're gonna burn yourself out. So it's not like, I don't even care, do it. And maybe you won't, maybe you'll consider it a 9-to-5, and like, you upload, like DMB Nation did, upload 15 videos a day. I don't know how they did that, honey. They must have been living at home, have no bills, they didn't have no kids. So I mean, I understand that, but like, 15 videos a day, my God, I can't. Is that window open? I can't chat. I struggle with one. I struggle when I be trying to, when I was doing my beauty videos and my wig reviews. You hot? I'm not hot, so you must be tripping. When I was doing those, and I would have like sponsored videos where like they sent me the hair and I had like a deadline to get the review and stuff up, I would do like a mass recording where basically I recorded like 4 or 5 videos in one day. So in between, I would change my hair, or I would change my shirt, I would change how I had my hair, I might put on my glasses, I might take my glasses off, I might change my lipstick, just to make it look like I'm doing these on different days, change the background, something. And I would just mass record, and then I would have these, and I would edit them. And or I would edit like one a day or whatever, but just because I didn't have time, because I was working full-time then, I was breastfeeding, had my son, just had my son, so I was going through a whole bunch. I didn't have time with my schedule to do all of that, to really like take consideration into YouTube. So I don't know how they did 15 videos a day unless they were all reaction and prank videos, because to be absolutely honest, those are like so easy to make. It does not take a lot of editing. You're literally just sitting there watching the video. If you get fancy with it, you may like insert the video in the bottom, or you might insert clips of the video in the bottom. But I don't know, I don't really see that too often either. But it's just like, see, I changed where I park at church. So now somebody got my old park and they be parking there every time. So, you know, I don't know what's going on with that. But yeah, so I don't know. But that's just not what I want to do with my channel. My nose feel like it's running. But I don't know, y'all. I'm about to go into church. I'm about to praise the Lord. I'm about to just give him glory for everything he's done in my life. I love y'all. I thank you guys for tuning in. And please don't forget to come.
Bye.
I hate doing that part. Don't forget to be yourself. Don't forget to love on God. And don't forget to be yourself. And if you're on a YouTube journey, continue on that journey. And peace.
Bye.
Eli says bye. I don't know if y'all can see my little bug.
Bye.
Say bye.
Bye.
My baby.
Bye.
Okay, baby.